This tutorial, I'm going to go over how to easily transfer files between your Mac and your Raspberry Pi. With a few setup tweaks, we can easily drop files back and forth between the Mac and the Raspberry Pi, making it easier to edit locally or edit remotely, and then simply transfer the files over to your Raspberry Pi. So first thing I'll pull up is the Finder. I click on that, this directory I've made called Pi. And I've got my Raspberry Pi connected. So I've already set it up. I can see it on VNC, and I can see that dex.local is connected. If you have any trouble with this, we recommend using Bonjour Browser, which is an easy way to detect devices on the network. You can see here that dex is connected. I can see dex.local on the network, and it's got its IP address listed and the IPv6 address listed. So no problem. Just wanted to, that would be the first step that we take on transferring files. So now that we know we're connected, we would go to Finder. So once we're in Finder, what we'll do is make a connection to the Raspberry Pi. And we'll bring it up. We've got favorites, we've got devices. These are things that are available on the Mac and some tags here, but we don't see the Raspberry Pi yet, even though we are connected. So what we're going to do is go to click on the Finder, and then under Finder, we'll click Go and connect to service to server. You can hit Command K to make a short or to easily shortcut to this. But when I click on Command Server, I've already got a suggestion for dex.local. So here it says smb:\\dex.local. That's the name of the Raspberry Pi. We want to connect. So if I hit Connect, it should take a few seconds. And it'll give me the option of what to mount. And the Raspberry Pi and Raspbian for Robots is already set up to default share Pi. So I just click OK. And a few things happen in my view here, but we've successfully connected. So let's look. Down here, I've got a new section called Shared, and these are devices that are shared. You can see that dex.local is now shared with me and with this Mac. So I can see into dex.local. If I go ahead and click on that, I'll actually refresh the connection. So it'll give me the option of looking again in the Pi folder. So this is home. This is on the Raspberry Pi. It's /home/Pi. And if I click on that, I can see all the files that are listed in my home directory. So on the Raspberry Pi. So I can actually do a couple of things that are interesting here. So let's go ahead and I've got an image of the GoPiGo in the home directory. Let's go ahead and double click on that. Yep, I can see it pretty easily on my Mac, just like that. Now, if I want to move that file over to my local directory, this is a folder I call Pi that's on my Mac. All I have to do is drag and drop. And see that the file is still in there in the Pi. That all it does is copy it, but now this is on my local Mac. So I could do whatever I want to. If I want to rename it, we'll try renaming it, and we'll transfer it right back. Call this the same thing, -2. So I've got a new file that doesn't exist on the Raspberry Pi, and if I drag it back, I can easily see now that I've got two of those GoPiGo Basekit assembled pictures. So that's great. And that's kind of how you transfer files back and forth between the Mac and the Raspberry. I'll show one more quick helpful example here. Let's say you're working on a text file. Here I've got just a brand new untitled text file, and I've just written "Hello Raspberry Pi, this is John," and I want to save this. I'm working on this on my Mac, and I want to save it on my Raspberry Pi. So all I would do is go up to File, and then use my usual, just as I would normally save it locally, I'd hit Save As. I'll get a dialog box here. So your dialog box may be a little compressed like this. You can, if you expand it out, you should be able to see different locations that are on your file system. We can see the usual spots on my MacBook that got these, but I've also got the dex.local, those that are shared with me. If I click on that, I should quickly be able to see the Pi directory, and I should be able to save this now as a text file. So we'll call this hello. Pi.txt. And if I save that, we'll go back to the Finder window that shows what's on the Raspberry Pi. Yep, we're looking here at the dex.local, the Raspberry Pi directory. and we called that one Hello Raspberry Pi, and that is now saved to the Raspberry Pi. So that's sort of an easy way that you can actually edit on your Raspberry Pi or edit on your Mac and easily transfer files back and forth or pull up a file that's on your Mac or on your Raspberry Pi and edit it on your Mac and then save it.